Okay guys, welcome back to the channel. This is the part two of assembling the Creality Ender 3 V3K. I've had a quick look through the booklet. It doesn't seem like it's going to be too long-winded. I've got the stopwatch here. I'm going to put that on, see how long this takes us. Okay, we're off and running. So the first step, it says in the book, is to put the gantry on. I've got head cam going, hopefully you can see that. So we've got a few plugs to put in, and it says step one, we've got to put this on, thread all this cable here through here, don't get it caught up on anything. Okay, that slips in, and then we slip the other side in there. Okay, now it says in the booklet here, so we've put that in, put the cable through, and it says to put three screws, which are these M314s that go underneath. But what I'm going to do first, I'm going to skip and I'm going to secure these two back ones. That'll give me a little bit more. Here they are. So we want the M3 by 8s, and that secures this back edge here. Let's get the right Allen key. I've got the kit out, everything laid out. Had a quick look through the book, just so I'm a little bit knowing what's going on. So I'm just going to basically get these buttoned in a little bit. I'm going to use all the tools they give me here, because that's what comes with it. I've got my own, but there's two more holes there, but it doesn't look like anything goes in those. So cable through, gantry on, normally now the three screws and then those two, but I've just done those two to give me something to hold it kind of steady. All right, now I think the best way to go here might be sideways even. Hold her steady. 3 minutes at the minute. Again with the right size thing. Just gonna snug them up. Anyway guys, if you haven't seen part one, unboxing, if you're looking into buying a printer, you click on the little tab I'll put up in the right hand corner and you can watch that video also and come back to this, or you can carry on with this and watch that after. It is up to you, but here we are. Now this one, I'm just going to get one in, just the one I can kind of see here, make sure we're feeling it. It feels good to me, snugging up. Can I get, I can probably get all those in there without moving the machine. So it's a fairly well put together thing out of the box. You don't have to mess around with too many parts. Certainly for people that are beginning, building anything can be tricky. I built the Anet A8 from scratch. That comes as a complete broken down kit. And that gave me some good insight into what everything does, how everything is. So we've got our cable coming through there, and I'm going to plug that in. But I'm going to go this way, underneath. Okay, we go under that strap, plug that in. They're all sheathed as well, so it's protected quite nicely. Poke that in there. Turn her back up. All right, now, next step it says here. Okay, to put the screen on. So, the screen on, and you want these screws, M4 by 10s. 6 minutes at the minute. All right, guys, I've got the head cam on. Looking lovely. Looking beautiful. Empty those out. Grab the same one, I think it's the same size. And we're going to place that. It'll be easier to turn this back over again. Do that trickier one up there first. Let's get it, threadle it through the hole here. put it on there. Okay, line it up, have a little look, lovely. Okay, no washers on these, just straight in. Okay, there's the two USB slots on the top of that also. I'll whiz through a bit of this, I think I'll whiz through. Snap them up, beautiful. Grab the connector, have a little look. There's a notch at the top, there's a notch on the connector. Okay, see which way round it's gonna be best, probably like that. And then slip that in there. All right, again, a little strap later on, maybe around there. A zip tie. But this is an upgrade, I think, from the V3, normal V3 is this touchscreen. Okay, so we're on there. Now, spool holder. This is saying to grab this. We want these two big boys here, which are the M5x8s. Crack them out. Let's have a look at this. It's probably a bigger key, yeah. Okay, and then this goes on. This goes on. Which way does this go on? Okay, we've got the arrow on here pointing down, filament sensor. Okay, it's got it showing on the other side though there. Okay, I might have this round the wrong way. Yeah, it goes on the other way, that guy, so oh, bear with me. Just quick swap. It's hard to see on the image, it's just the sensor was round the other way. Okay, flip that round. Makes sense in a way because it looks better that way round. I'll take this off again, flip that round. Then it says to plug this in. Again, there's only two slots on there, that's one way it can go on. Some kind of clipping thing, some kind of rubber thing here. We'll get to that, we'll get to that. Okay, so first insert the nozzle wire into the nozzle adapter plane. All right, it's asking me now to insert this wire into the adapter plane. All right, oh yeah. So in this packet here, you get, looks like a spare nozzle, which is nice. And then it wants us to clip this on here. There's a deeper slot and a thinner slot. So we go deeper. That's secured in there, lovely jubbly. Now we've got this, following the wire label instructions, first insert the extruder line into the cable fixing clip and then it connect X-axis motor. It does. Goes around the back, guys. Goes around the back. So off we come again with our clip. Get our screw out of here. Oh no, there goes the bloody screw. Oh. Then, right, I've lost the screw in the extruder. Let's see if I can wiggle that out. Oh, what a son of a gun, hey? There it is. Whew. All right, guys, don't drop your screw. Don't drop your screw down that little slit there. Holy moly. Right, here we go again then. So we've gone round the back. Put back in here, pins are lined up. Push that down and clip them together. Whiz forward this bit, eh? We'll whiz forward. Okay, yeah, if you put your screws on the Allen key first, it's easier to get them in there. This is probably the more technical bit here, I feel. Make sure this bit isn't pinched. Righty, so now. Pull that forward, spin it around. Okay, it's asking us here, get off the black positioning label of the flexible flat cable, FFC, stuck at the line claw. That'll be it there. They want you to take this off here. Okay, take off the labes, and then we get that in here somehow. Thread all that in here. And that looks like about it. It's very small and very weird to look at that. It looks like it just goes into there like that though. So we'll have kind of full range of motion up. And then it wants us to plug this into the stepper. We'll plug that in there. Okay guys. And then down here, so now we have a connect the Z-axis. Please ensure proper wiring according to provided diagram and avoid overturning and folding the extruder cable. All right, this is taped down. Get rid of that. And we're gonna plug him in. All right, that goes in there. All right, that's in. The tape is just there to hold that together. That for me is pretty good. I mean, I can't see that going in anymore, guys. So there we are. Okay, and the next step then, it's talking about loading filament and getting going with the touch screen. Now, plugging the power switch in, which is in there with the main cord, which is here. So guys, we've done it. All I've got left is the tools and the spare nozzle. That's how it's put together. No real issue, but I didn't see this strap needs to go behind. So, a bit silly, really, on my part. A little bit silly on my part. She does slip very nice. That's connected to there. Steppers are in, that back stepper's on, that's on. Extruder main cable is in here. Everything else is kind of put together. I'll check it over, you know, make sure everything's running. But that's how she goes together, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Join me in part three. All right, there'll be three parts. Someone building now. I'll get this running and I'll take you through the screen, everything else. I'm learning as you're going with me. All right, we're learning together, guys. So hit the buttons, join the channel. And there'll be more coming up on this printing malarkey, all right? 26 minutes. It could have been quicker, but I've been chatting. So I'll see you in the next video, guys. Take care.